So hello all, I am Tirthesh, you are watching Techmania World of Knowledge. So today in this class, let us learn how do we reduce the K-map expression. So one by one, let us go through the steps. So in the previous classes, you have learned what is a K-map and how do we draw a K-map. What are the rules and regulations to draw a K-map? So whenever you are going to do a K-map always says that whenever you have an input, two input means 2 to the power of n, which is equal to 2 to the power of 2, which is equal to 4. You should have 4 boxes for 2 to the power of 2. Where when you have x, sin, y as the input. Now when you have x, y, z, so what does it happen? 2 to the power of 3. 2 to the power of 3 means 2 into 2 into 2. So 2 to the 4, 4 to the 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So 8 boxes. So whenever you have to 3 inputs, you get 8 boxes, means here x, y, z. So when you have 4 inputs, w, x, y, z, what you are going to do? You are going to work for 2 to the power of 4, means you have 4 inputs called as w, x, y, z. So what you should do, there are 4 inputs, means 2 is always common because we are dealing with Boolean algebra. When you are doing with Boolean algebra, you have only 2 variables, that it is true, or either it is true or it is false. So there are only the 2 variables. So when 2 to the power of 4 means you should multiply with 4. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So which you get 16 boxes. So this is what a variable declaration. So we have 2 variable K-map, 3 variable K-map and 4 variable K-map. So whenever you are going to work on K-map, so how do we work on, or what are the rules and regulations to carry on the K-map? So hear it carefully and understand this properly. So, for how do you reduce the expression? So, whenever you are going to reduce the K-map, first you should reduce an expression adjacent 1 and 0 are encircled. So, how do you write 1 and 0? Say for the example, you have a question called as a function of w, x, y, z, which is equal to sigma, means always it represents SOP format. Whenever you have SOP format, your output will be 1. So now 0, or let me take some sums as 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11 and 13. So this is how you are going to get. This is that reduce the expression using a K-map format. So whatever they have given, 1, right? Here you have these numbers, right? For this number, when your expression is in SOP format, the placeholder must consist 1. Say for example, here 1 means here you have 1, you are going to write 1 over here. Okay? Next, 3 means you are going to write 3 over here. 1. Okay, next 5. 5, 1. Sign what we have? 6 also it is 1. Where is 6 now? 6, 1. Next, 7 also it is 1. Next, 9. 9, it is 1. And 11 it is 1. 11 it is 1. Next, 13 it is 1. Okay? So now, this is how first step you should consider. You should do for wherever you have a number like 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 13. Is there, right? In that places you should substitute 1 when you have SOP, but when you have viewers as pi, then in these places you should substitute 0. Remember that thing. When you have sigma, you should substitute 1. When you have pi, you should substitute 0. Next, letter. Wherever you doesn't have any terms, right, you just put 0s over there. So just put 0s over there. So wherever you doesn't have any terms, you are going to put 0s over there. Okay? So, this is how the first step. First, what you should do? You should check the question. And if you have sigma over there, then you are going to work on the sum of product, where your output will be 1. When you have a pi over here, you are going to work on product of sum, then the placeholders must consist 0 in place of 1. Next, what they say? To reduce an expression, adjacent 1s and 0s are encircled. To reduce an expression, adjacent 1s and 0s are encircled. Like this. Now you have 1, right? So what you should do? You are going to encircle them. If you have one, you are going to encircle them. Okay? Next, like that you should do. But how do I do that? So whenever you are going to encircle, remember these 3 points. Okay? The two adjacent numbers, 1700 adjacent, 1700 are encircled. Like I do only two numbers, then this is known as pair. Remember, when two numbers, two adjacent ones are encircled, then this is known as pair. When four adjacent ones are encircled like this, when four adjacent ones are encircled, then it is known as quad. Understood? So when two adjacent ones and zeros are encircled, then it is known as quad pair. When four adjacent and ones and zeros are encircled, then it is known as octet, quad. Now, when four adjacent ones like this, when you have only in a straight line ones, if you are going to encircle them, then this is known as octet. O C T A T. Okay, that is known as T E octet. This is known as octet. So this is how you are going to encircle. But when you are going to encircle, first always you should check for whether you have an octet. When you have octet, you should circle them directly. When you have octet, you should circle them directly. Okay. Next, after that, what you should do? You should check for quad. You should check for quad. Last, what you should do? You should check for pair. Lastly, you are going to work for pair. Clear? So first, always you should work on octet. Next, quad. After that, pair. So this is how you are going to reduce the expression. The rules to reduce the expression. What you should do? First, given numbers, the given placeholders must be filled with ones if you have a SOP. And if you have the POS, you should fill them with the zero. Second, to reduce an expression, you should encircle ones or zeros. You should be encircled. You should encircle ones or zeros. How do you encircle ones or zeros, and what is the name given to them? If you encircle two ones, then it is known as pair. If you encircle four numbers, then it is known as quad. If you encircle eight numbers, then it is known as octet. Why I am saying eight numbers? You can see here one difference and difference. So whenever you have a two difference or four difference, then it is octet. Means it should come in a straight line, or it may be anyhow. Like if you have ones like this, for example, if you have ones like this, you are going to encircle them like this. Or if you have ones like this, then you are going to encircle them like this. Clear? This is how you are going to do for a reducing an expression. So when after reducing expression, how do you pair them? So you all know, you in SOP format, let me write it properly and I'll explain you. You all know that when you are going to work on SOP format, you are going to neglect A plus A bar, or A bar plus A, it has been neglected. Okay, so how do you neglect that A bar plus A? So of course, okay, so here to remove the variable which changes its state from complement to uncomplement. This is a complement and this is uncomplement. When it changes from complement to uncomplement using a or symbol, then it has been neglected or removed. Okay, next, pair the removed only format. For example, I may take this one. Okay, this quad. So it is W bar X bar W bar X W X bar. Okay, Y bar Z Y Z and Y Z bar. Okay, now let me take one thing. Now let me take this only chord. Check that we have only chord. Okay, you doesn't have a octet. You have only chord. Okay. So how do you take them? So let me explain you in briefly. Then let us move in short method. Okay. So now here W bar X plus into W bar X into Y bar Z. Like I have written right. W bar X bar Y bar Z. W bar X bar Y Z. Have you written right like that? So you should see that. Okay. Now here W bar X bar into Y bar Z bar, because this row, this consists of this one and this one, for that reason. Next, this one and this one, full completely. Okay. First you should multiply this together, right? So after that this together. So what do you get now? So now you are going to get W bar X bar Y bar and Z. Okay, Y bar and Z. Next, plus W bar X bar X bar Y W bar X bar Y Z. Okay, W bar X bar Y Z. So what is here common? You are going to check for common out right now. So now this end, this is common, and this side W bar X Y W bar X bar Y Z, right? So now, so here Y and Y bar is different, right? So what you should do, W bar X bar Z, W bar X bar Y Z Z into Y bar plus Y. So when you have Y bar plus Y, it is equal to 1. Understood? So your answer will be W bar X bar and Z. W bar X bar and Z. So this is how you are going to take out. But when you have an octet, you are going to concentrate on only single statement called as this. If you have this as the octet, then your answer, your reduced expression will be Y bar and Z. Clear? When you have a pair, W bar X bar, W bar X bar. So together one line, right? So plus W bar W X bar. So plus W X bar. So this is how you are going to work when you have an octet and pair. Clear? So now let us check briefly how do we do. Now let me take one sum, proper sum, and I will explain it. Okay? So reduce the expression, reduce the K-map, reduce the K-map, okay, when f of A, B, C, D, f of A, B, C, D is equals to sigma of 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 9, 13. Okay. First thing what you should do here, you should check for input. Now, the formula for K-map is 2 to the power of n. N means it is number of inputs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, which is equals to 2 to the power of 4, which is equals to 2 to the power of 4 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So which is equals to 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8 to the 16. So what you should do? You should draw a K-map which consists of 16 boxes. So let us draw a K-map which consists of 16 boxes first. First work is you should draw a K-map which consists of 16 boxes. Okay? So K-map with 16 boxes. So now, here 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 fours are 16 boxes. So next. So what you should do? A bar C D means here A B C and D. Okay, now let us count. 0 0 0 1 1 1 and 1 0. 0 0 0 1 1 1 and 1 0. Clear. Now let us put the placeholders. 0 1 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So this is how I numbered them. Now what I should do, I should put outputs, right? Now I should put outputs. So now what I should do, I should see the numbers over here. Here 1 means you are going to put 1 in here because it is in SOP format. Next 3. Next 5. Next 6. 6. Okay. 6. 6. After that 7, then to 11 you have number, 9 you have number, and 13 you have number. So now what you should do, you should answer the rest of the things with zeros. This is your first work. Now what you should do, you should check for the numbers, alright. Let me write completely here, okay, so that you will not get confused. Now okay, A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B, A, A, B bar. Okay, so A bar after that, C bar, D bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. Okay, so now what you should do? Now you should check for, first what you should do, you should check for octet. Okay, so now firstly I am going to check for octet. Okay, so this is octet, means O1. Next what you should do, after finishing octet, if you have check for octet, doesn't have octet, next what you should do, you should check for pair. So quad. So when you check for quad, you should have a proper square. So this has a proper square, so you are going to write this as a quad, Q1. Okay, next, after finishing quad, again you are not supposed to do this. Next you should check for pay. One pay, you always, one KMM must consist at least one octet and one pair, or all the three. So now one pair. Okay. So this is how we are going to reduce them. Now let us reduce this expression. Okay. Now what you should do, first for, let us write for octet. Okay. O1. Means what is the numbers you have? So M1, 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 M5, M1, M5, M13, M13, M9. Next, Q1 means quad one. Okay, M1, M3, M5, and M7. So M1, M3, M5, and M7. Next, pair. Pair means M9 and M11. Okay. Now reduced expression. Okay. Now this is the there are how many quads? One quad, one octet, one quad, and one pair. After that, reduced expression. So how do you do reduced expression? Quad octet one, Q O O 1. So O1, which is equals to, you can see over here, straightly you have one, means only one thing you are called as C bar and D. Okay. Next. Here you have to check this one. So here which is a common now Q1, right? So here you have to check. Now because one you have both the sides, right? Which is common now? A bar is common. So B bar and B I am going to neglect that. So A bar here which is common, D is common, like that. Means here you can check here. This is here. This thing is common, right? So for only one term you are going to write. Okay. B bar plus B which is equals to 1. 1 into A bar itself. Means see here properly now. Once again I am going to write properly, okay? Because this one has here, this line you have one, and this line also you have one. So what you should do, A bar B bar plus A bar B. So here which is common? A bar is common, B bar plus B. So B bar plus B means A bar into 1, which is equals to A bar. Next, here you check out. C bar D plus C D. What is common here? D is common. C bar plus C, which is equals to D into 1, which is equal to D. So together it is called as AD. And also A bar D. Now pair. Okay. Now pair means how do you do? A bar, B bar, C bar, D plus only this line, and we have one in two pairs. Means A bar, B bar, C bar, D plus CD. Okay? C bar B plus CD. Now what, which are common here? This is common here, right? A bar, B bar, D into C bar plus C. Means why I am going to take, as already I have said that complement must be, I should remove complemented variable and uncomplemented variable. Means C bar is a complemented variable, C is uncomplemented variable. So what does it become? A, B bar, D, which is into 1 into 1. So A, B bar, D. Okay, A, B bar, D. So what one, so this pair one will be A, B bar, D. Okay, next, the final expression. So then the final expression, how you want to write? Final expression. So the final expression will be C bar D plus A bar D plus A B bar and D. Okay, A B bar and D. This is your final expression. So hope you understood this concept. So understand C again and again until you understand properly. So what is this here? Here I am going to reduce the expression. To reduce the expression, what are the format, what are the rules and regulations are there, I have showed in this video. So I hope you understood this video. If you have any doubts or queries regarding this concept, please do contact me. Thank you.